Praxis Prepper.
Mimi!
Hey everybody, this is Praxis. I'm not a huge fan of predictions in general. In fact, my approach to emergency preparedness is to kind of just think about things in terms of probabilities. You know, like what are the possible things that could happen? And if you prepare against many or most of those, then you're probably going to be looking pretty good whether or not you know exactly what was going to happen. But today is election day here in the United States, and I thought it might be fun to share with you my thoughts. I do have a prediction about the way that I think it's going to go, and I thought it might be fun to share that with you. First off, I should say that I don't think we're going to know for sure whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong by the end of the day today or early tomorrow, you know, just with the pandemic and people's mail-in voting and things being a little bit of chaos this year. I mean, everything in our society is nuts. You go to the RMV and it's like, you know, crazy. You go to the store and it's crazy. You know, so why would the election be any different? We will get a result. It will come in, but it'll be a little bit delayed, and that's okay. I mean, when the United States started, we certainly didn't know the day after an election exactly who had won. That's the way the rules and the laws are written, and, you know, while we've been treated to instant results for the past, you know, several years, we'll get through it this time. We'll find out whether or not I'm right or wrong. So first, I'm going to share my prediction with you, and then I'll give you a little bit of the logic behind it. It's mostly logic. I should say that I'm not drawing my thoughts about this from, you know, mass media news or whatever. Frequently when I do a video, people will, if they disagree with me, and that's pretty frequent, you know, people say, oh, you get all your news from CNN. Or, you know, if, it's the other way that people say, oh, all you do is listen to Fox. I should let you know, I haven't had cable television or television at all for decades. I don't listen to any of that kind of junk. It is just there to sell commercials. I mean, there's some good, useful bits in there, but it's so few and far between that you have to dig so much through it. It's just, I don't utilize it, and that's not where I'm getting my information. It's really a logic-based decision that I'm making at this point, and I'll share with you the logic after I tell you what my prediction is, and I'll tell you the prediction right now. I think Biden's going to win. The reason that I think that is because, if you look back to 2016, it was a razor close margin on that election. It was Trump versus Hillary Clinton, and Trump obviously won, you know, through the Electoral College. Clinton, you know, technically got more votes, but that's not the way we do it here. I don't know whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. There are pros and cons against the Electoral College and for it. That's not what this video is about. But functionally, it was a tie. It was so darn close. If Trump had sneezed the wrong way and the election had been held the next day, maybe Clinton would have won. It was a tie. It was so close. So no matter who won that election, nobody could have claimed a mandate because it was functionally a tie. Now, of course, politicians, they always claim a mandate anyway, and Trump was no different. But it was so close that time. And it was so close with people not really knowing about Trump. He had a lot of rhetoric. He talked about draining the swamp and term limits for senators and all these other things. And he was an unknown commodity. People didn't really know what to expect from him. There were people that had hope that they put in him. I didn't vote for Trump. I didn't vote for Hillary Clinton either. I couldn't bring myself to vote for either. I mean, Clinton was just, she's like kind of like another brick in the wall. That was the way that I saw it. And Trump was just, he was a dice roll. I ended up going for the Libertarian candidate, Gary Johnson. You guys might remember him because he had botched some interview at some point when he like forgot the name of some Syrian city or something like that. I forget what it was. But the point is that when it was the last time around, it was pretty much the same thing. You had Hillary Clinton, who is a really unappealing candidate to a lot of people. Just nobody was really getting excited about her. I mean, it was cool that she was a woman, if you want to be sexist about it. I mean, I would have thought that would be kind of just neat and novel, the first, woman president in the United States. But aside from that, again, she was just, another brick in the wall kind of candidate, nothing to really get all that excited about. And even then, Trump barely beat her. This time around, we've got another really boring Democratic candidate. Biden, of all the candidates the Democrats had running, I think he was the least exciting of all of them. There were some really cool candidates that had some really big ideas. Where our country is right now, we need big ideas. We've got a lot of problems facing us. We need someone with big, new, fresh ideas, and that's not Joe Biden. But the point of this video, and why I'm trashing Joe Biden, but I'm saying he's going to win, the point is that that person is not Trump either. And people know that now. We've had 4 years to see what a Trump presidency would be like. He's no longer an unknown commodity. He's no longer a dice roll. People know exactly what they're getting from him. And what they're getting from Trump, as we've seen, is pretty much nothing. The U.S. really hasn't accomplished anything over the past 4 years. The rest of the world has been running circles around us, taking advantage of the chaos here that is, you know, largely created by Trump. I know we got all sorts of other issues, too. You can't blame everything on Trump. But a lot of Trump, of what Trump has brought to the U.S. presidency has been uncertainty, has been chaos, and it's stymied a lot of U.S. progress forward. China has taken advantage of that. Russia has taken advantage of that. There are other nations and corporations that have taken advantage of that. We have not drained the swamp. And while there are still tons and tons and tons of people that are just crazy pro-Trump, you know, no matter what, it's Trump, Trump, Trump. All the people that were kind of on the fence, myself included, when Trump got elected initially, I didn't vote for him, but I was thinking, you know, maybe he'll be able to do it. You know, maybe he's going to be able to pull this off. You know, he's fresh. He's coming from the outside. Maybe he really will drain the swamp. Maybe he really will put term limits in for senators. Maybe he really will initiate a nationwide concealed carry so you don't have to, like, you know, state to state when you have a firearm. It's like a whole ordeal trying to just travel through your own country as you go state to state. Maybe some of these great big ideas that he's talking about he's actually going to implement and make happen. And he really hasn't. He hasn't really done anything. He's caused a lot of, arguments. There have been, you know, fights. There have been name-calling. There's been a lot of childish behavior. But the only real accomplishments that have been attributed to Trump are things like federal judges, and that's really a Mitch McConnell achievement that's just rebranded as a Trump achievement. So, while there are still plenty of Trump supporters that are just pro-Trump no matter what, I think there are a lot of people that, in fact, I think most people were kind of like maybe on the line like I was, where we, you know, wanted to hope for the best and see where things go. And we saw where things went, and, you know, now at this point we kind of know. And I think this time around there's going to be a lot of people who were like me that last time around might have thrown their vote away on Gary Johnson, the Libertarian candidate, and this time are just kind of fed up with the United States being in this situation where it's just not getting anything done, the rest of the world is going past us, and we're just in this kind of like perpetual second grade schoolyard quarrel. And, you know, we're tired of that, and we want to see something different. And while Biden is anything but different historically in the United States, he's just more the same Biden, maybe another brick in the wall. You know, maybe another brick in the wall at this point is better than a perpetual, you know, cable news TV screaming match that we've been doing for the past 4 years. So I think there's enough people that are like me in that regard that are going to just, you know, move us away from Trump, and that's why I think that he's going to lose this election. I know there's going to be a lot of people that are going to be kind of deflated by that, if that happens. And again, you know, I don't have a crystal ball. This is just my guess based on logic. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. You know, if what I'm saying is correct, we're going to have another 4 years of a different kind of sitting around and not doing anything. We're going to be going back to kind of like a status quo sort of thing, like the way things had been in the past. And that wasn't awesome either. You know, a lot of the reasons that, people became preppers is because the way that our society was functioning was very short-term thinking, was not looking towards the future and making big solutions. So, you know, really, no matter who wins this election, keep prepping, because, you know, the systemic issues that are facing our country and our world, you know, they're not going away based on, you know, someone that you elect, especially if it's going to be a Donald Trump or a Joe Biden, because neither one of those people are a solution to really what ails us. The solution really has to come from all of us, and, you know, it's good to have leaders that can motivate and, share ideas, but, you know, an election isn't going to necessarily change the world. I think it'll change the flavor of what's going on here in the United States. I think there are some things that'll get better. Maybe there are some things that'll get worse. But the point is, no matter who wins, keep prepping. The problems that have been facing us are still there, and we have yet to find someone that has any real solutions to them. That's not true. There's plenty of people that have real solutions to them, but we have yet to find anyone that is gaining any political power that has any solutions to the problems that are facing us. So we'll see. Maybe in, what is it? Maybe in 2024, we'll have some great candidates. And, we can see what happens then. So that's it. Let me know in the comments below whether you think I'm right, whether you think I'm wrong. Please keep your comments related to this video. I get so many, especially the video I did last time on masking. People are talking about all sorts of other things. Keep the comments related to the topic at hand, and don't project into me any beliefs that you wish that I had so you could yell at me for them. Unless you really, really got to do it. If you do it, do it in all caps because it's more effective that way. That's it. Thanks for watching. This episode is brought to you in part by Burning Hearth Homestead, a nonprofit that aims to provide seeds, live plants, and education to the community, both local and extended. Plant seeds, plant knowledge, plant the future. If you'd like to thank them for supporting this channel or find out more about what they do, go to burninghearthhomestead.org. Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.